the aim of this system is to create a counterposition between Russia and Europe. From the technical point of view, this is creating a system through which the United States will be able to watch very deep inside the territory of Russia. And from the third point of view, also political, this way is a very good system to divide Europe, which already happened, in fact. Look at the position of the American administration. They are our ally in NATO. A correct behavior of an ally would be to inform of its moves its own allies. But they did not inform at all the European about their intention. They went straight to Warsaw and here to Prague to take an agreement with two different European governments. They did not inform the European Commission about that. They did not inform the Council of Ministers of the the European Union. Mm-hmm. They did not inform the European Parliament. They did not inform the NATO headquarters. Which showed that the intentions are not clear. I am here in Prague, and I am very glad to be here with my friends, because I would like to inform you that the European Parliament never discussed this question till now. There is no any political resolution of Europe on this question. Well, certainly there have been some meeting of experts in the NATO headquarters, in some commission of the parliament, but no resolution, no political position. Europe has not any political official position on that. Or you, certainly everybody can have a different position on this question, but the question is that evidently the new missile system to put inside Europe has a very big importance for the European security. How can we imagine that this kind of question is discussed by the United States with Warsaw and with Prague without consulting the rest of Europe? How we can say that we consider Europe a very important task if we destroy the unity of Europe and if we put Europe in a difficult, divided situation? For that reason, I came here to try to understand what is happening in this country and which kind of decision can be taken in this country in the future. I will come back with more information, and I am glad that today I met a group of mayors of different cities in the zone interested, and I have seen, moreover, that the majority of the population here is against the placement of the radar. Well, and from the other side, I can tell you that the level of information inside the European Parliament on this question is very low. That means that one of the tasks I would like to fulfill in the next future is to promote an open overall discussion on this question, because I believe that the European Parliament should have a position, official position, to count. I would like to know how many members of the Parliament are for and how many members are against. It would be a very good information from the very beginning. Also because, the impression I have is that we are, as I told at the very beginning, we are facing a very big international crisis. We will have to face in the next years five big crises in the world. The first is the energy crisis, the second is the water crisis, the third is the food crisis, the fourth is the climate change crisis, and the fifth is the demographic crisis. Altogether, we are at the very beginning of a very difficult period of time. We have to face question of security. Yes, the question of security is very big, but it is a completely different question of security. For instance, only climate change situation will produce, even if we stay inside the 2 degrees of heating of the atmosphere, we have to face only to defend ourselves from the catastrophic effects of heating. We have to spend every year something like 800 billion euro only for defense. Well, also about climate change, if the trend will go on with the pace they are going on now, we will have to face the displacement of more than 300 million people on the Earth. This will require huge expenses and huge technical and organizational transformation. Well, and when we are facing all these problems, and in the future they will become bigger and bigger, we face a proposal to spend $50 billion to create a new missile system, which does not make any sense at all. For all this reason, we should say to our allies, United States, that we don't need that. We don't want that system of missiles. And for that reason, we should speak clearly to our allies that we need another way of behavior. We need a new system of security. Yes, international security, it's necessary. Yes, but it is not a military system of defense. We need a new way of coordinate our efforts to create a common security. Europe is now a big power, and I believe that Europe should be united to face all these dangers. I hope that the new American President Barack Obama will be able to understand that the unipolar world is finished, and he begins to understand that the world is differentiated, and that is also in their interest if Europe will become united more than today. And the last problem, I see that the media here, like in Italy, like in Europe, are not covering clearly very well this problem. Unfortunately, the majority of the population in Europe, in Italy, in the Czech Republic, and elsewhere, is not informed about the question we are discussing here today. I believe that it is not a normal situation, because if we see that the majority of the population does not know what is going on, the question is, where is democracy? This is an absolutely abnormal situation. Somebody here in the world is taking decision regarding your life, our life, and no one is informed about that. This is not a democratic situation, as you can understand. Thank you very much.